Colossians chapter 3 and verse 16 says, "Let the word of God dwell in you richly, in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord." So Paul is writing to the church in Colossae and he's saying, let the word of God dwell in you, abide in you, not meagerly, but richly. Right? The question we need to ask is, does the word of God have unlimited access or the right of way in my heart and in my mind? This word of God, which is life itself, does it have unlimited access into my life? The second question, you know, have I given the word of God the kind of welcome and the place of importance it deserves in my life? Thirdly, have I intentionally made it a point to let the word of God stay, abide, and dwell in my heart richly? The word dwell refers to someone who takes up permanent residence. It does not refer to someone who visits and leaves, or who is acquainted as a stranger and then leaves. But it talks about someone who is familiar, who decides to stay, who takes up permanent residence in a place, a permanent dwelling place, right? So the writer here, Paul, is saying, you know, let the word of God dwell. Let the word of God take permanent residence in your heart. Another question that we can ask ourselves is this: does the word of God have a comfortable, permanent place of stay in my life? Or is the word of God treated, or do I treat the word of God like a stranger and who is occasionally welcomed like a visitor in my life? You know, this is a very important question we need to reflect and ask ourselves. So the word of God, we know, is living and powerful. It is alive and living and powerful. It is a discerner of thoughts and intents of the heart. The word of God produces and builds faith in our heart, and without which we cannot please God. Without faith, we cannot live the life of a believer. The word of God also instructs us and guides us. The psalmist says that the word of God is a lamp to our feet and a light to our path. The word of God protects us when we have a tendency to wander away from the ways of God, away from the path of God. So the word of God is like the psalmist says, your word I have hidden in my heart that I may not sin against you. The word of God breaks strongholds. In fact, God himself says in the book of Jeremiah that his word is like a hammer that breaks the rock in pieces. So it's like a hammer. It's very strong. It breaks strongholds. It breaks hardened hearts. And the word of God also purifies. It's like a fire that burns away the chaff. It's like water that washes and cleanses. So the word of God purifies. In this epistle to Colossians, Paul writes and he says, let this word which can accomplish all this, this word of God which has all these characteristics, let this word dwell in you, stay in you, take permanent residence in you richly. And then he says, so that you might in wisdom teach, admonish one another, and also with hymns and spiritual songs, sing with grace in our hearts to one another. So the word of God causes us to do this. So may we give the word of God the prominence and the place it deserves in our lives. And may it enrich us personally, and may it flow out to enrich others' lives as well. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for your word. We thank you that your word is alive and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword. We thank you that your word is creative. It creates, oh God. Your word heals, Lord. And Lord, today we ask and we pray, let your word dwell in us richly. Lord, cause us to give your word the place, the importance in our lives. And may your word dwell in us richly today, and to enrich our lives and to enrich others' lives as well. We thank you in Jesus' name.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.